our book is the story of the Deepwater Horizon, the men and women involved with building the rig, managing the rig, all the way up to the explosion, and then the amazing rescue of the personnel on board the rig. One of the primary characters of the book is the rig itself. The Deepwater Horizon drilled the deepest offshore oil well ever drilled. It won safety awards from the government and BP itself. And we trace the rig from its being built in Korea all the way through moving the rig under its own power to the Gulf of Mexico, and how the rig really was its own self-sufficient island. And this was a crew that was really dedicated to operating the ship for 10 years without ever going ashore, maintaining a self-sufficient community. These guys worked, lived, slept, and led their whole lives on this rig with very little support from shore. A lot of the news media and the other books have concentrated on the environmental angle and the politics behind drilling. We really realized this was a story of people, people working every day on the rigs, away from their families, away from home. And after the explosion, these people lost the second family and a rig that many of them helped build. It was a real tragic loss for them. These people were the focus of our story. Transocean, the owner of the rig, was very focused on safety, but they were focused on safety, preventing hand injuries, back injuries, other occupational safety hazards. What got lost in the corporate mix was a wider view on big scale disasters, explosions, blowout of the type seen on the horizon. Unless we really look at the human element and manage the worst case scenarios on these rigs, this is a story that could happen again.